Lord Jesus Christ commanded us to love our neighbors as like ourselves. So I hope you all enjoy our music and then enjoy our gathering. Today we have lots of programs. So if you don't have a program, please let us know. We will bring the program for you. And after the concert, we will have some refreshment together. So please join our refreshment. Okay, let's begin our concert. So our concert will begin with a cello solo. So please join me to welcome our own cellist, organist, Nathan DeBoer.
Thank you. Music has such a power to take our heart away from the cares and worries of this life into another place. And I thank God for music and for the wonderful musicians that we are hearing this evening. As the music pauses, I want to share with you briefly why our concert is titled God First Loved Us. We live in a world where many are confused about who God is and what he's like, and how to think about him and how to find him and how to enjoy his love. And as we celebrate a Lunar New Year, many of us are lonely. I know for many immigrants it can be a difficult time because they're far away from family or friends, maybe even have lost loved ones. But you don't have to be confused. There is a God who first loved us, and I want to tell you briefly about this God. It's the living God. He created all things. He made us. He made you. He made us with a purpose to think, to feel, to create, and to enjoy life in an everlasting relationship with him. But humanity, you and I included, we strayed from this divine path. Instead, we chased after things he made rather than enjoyed relationship with him. We chased after wealth, success, pleasure. The Bible tells us we committed spiritual adultery. We replaced the living God for earthly idols and pursuit. And this betrayal, it leads to great shame and feelings of guilt that we try to hide. But the story, it doesn't end there. Despite our betrayal, God's love remained steadfast. God took decisive action to restore our relationship with him. This is a story of about 2,000 years ago in ancient land of Israel. God incarnated as the person of Jesus Christ. God came to earth to demonstrate his love. In a world of darkness, shame, and hopelessness, Jesus offered salvation and renewal. He showed us God's love. It's remarkable if you think of that. Despite our betrayal and unfaithfulness, God didn't stand far off and wait for us to come back to him. God came to us. He loved us first. This profound love is shown by God in Jesus' sacrificial death on the cross. It's on the cross that he takes all of the consequence of our betrayal upon himself. It's on the cross where he takes your shame, your guilt, and he says, I will carry that away from you. Through this act, God shows us that he doesn't hold our sins against us, but instead offers complete forgiveness and acceptance. And so the good news for you and I today is that regardless of our past mistakes or sins, regardless of how we have thought or acted towards God, we can embrace God's love anew. We turn away from sin, we place our faith in Jesus Christ, we can experience the fullness of his love and restoration. And we don't just have to hope that music will transport us for a moment, because we have an everlasting life of love with God. As a church here in Richmond Hill, we go through life together believing in Jesus Christ. We're part of the unified family of God. It's a family that transcends culture, language barriers. We'll have one of our elders, Elder Joseph Yu, share this message briefly in Mandarin with you as well. But we have a family united under one Heavenly Father. His love envelops us, and then his word and spirit guides us in affection and love for each other and mutual care. Now, as a pastor here of Bethel Church, I extend an invitation to you as well. This family is also for you to turn away from sin, embrace the boundless love of God revealed in Jesus Christ. And this concert is just one way that we seek to show to you and to others that God first loved us. In the family of God, and also here at Bethel Church, there is room for you. We gather weekly to lift our voices in worship, to be reminded of the immeasurable love of God, and to heed his gentle guidance for our lives. And so if you'd like to know more, Pastor Park, who introduced himself briefly, myself, or Elder Joseph Yu, we are here after the concert as well. We'd love to talk to you more. It's my prayer that this encounter, this evening you encounter the transformative power of God's love and seek his face in worship, being thankful that he first loved us. So I'd like now to invite Elder Yu to share this message briefly in Mandarin with you.
各位来宾，大家晚上好。真的是非常高兴能够看到大家来参加今天晚上的伯特利农历新年音乐会。那今天又是元宵佳节，真是对我们华人来讲是有特殊纪念意义的日子，是一个团圆的日子。那我也祝愿大家今天能够度过一个令人难忘的夜晚，在音乐中享受一切的美好。 那我是Joseph，是这间教会的一位长老。那我也代表教会，首先向所有现演今晚这场音乐会的所有的音乐家表达感谢，因为他们确实付出了时间、付出了精力来为我们预备今晚的音乐会。我们是非衷心的感谢他们付出的一切，也愿上帝纪念他们的付出。那我也在借此机会呢，感谢本教会的 Gerrit Bruintjes牧师，他刚刚也是从圣经的角度来帮我们去简单的解释了今晚音乐会的主题，也就是我们爱，因为上帝先爱我们这个主题的圣经的意思是什么。那我想，也趁着还有几分钟可以给音乐家们休息的这个时间，我也用说中文的方式也为大家分享一下今天这个音乐会主题。 是什么样的一个意思？那其实这句话"我们爱，因为上帝先爱我们"，这是出自于圣经新约《约翰一书》4章19节的一节经文。那其实使徒约翰在写下这句经文之前，他已经花了不少的篇幅去解释爱这个主题，什么是爱，然后他才得到了这样一个结论。那 关于爱这个主题，我相信我们每一个人其实都是有自己的认识和自己的经历的。我们爱我们自己的年长的父母，因为他们把我们养育长大；我们也爱我们的孩子，因为我们的孩子就好像我们生命的延续；我们爱我们的朋友，我们爱我们的同一个社区的邻舍；我们爱许许多多的美好的事物。 甚至有可能我们热爱我们的工作，我们热爱大自然，热爱美丽的风景，甚至我们有可能热爱音乐、热爱艺术、热爱美术。我们每个人都有这样的，可能都有这样的一种经历。但是我不知道大家有没有发觉，当我们有这样的爱的时候，所有我刚刚前面提到的这一些，似乎都变成了一种我们爱的一个对象，而我们呢？ 却成为了爱的一个源头，好像爱是从我们生命中发出去的，我们是一个源头。但是，使徒约翰在这里，就是我们今天的主题的音乐主题，这些经文他却说"我们爱，因为上帝先爱我们"，他似乎在尝试着给我们做一种扭转。 一种次序的一种扭转，我相信大家可以略微的可以感受到这一点点的这种扭转次序的改变。那我想，其实对于我们华人，特别是很多以前有生活在中国的经历的，或者说不是在这里长大的，是在中国长大的啊，我们多多少少受到一些中国文化的影响，儒家思想的影响。在儒家的思想里面，其实有一本书叫《大学》。 他其中有一句话，他是这么说的，他说物有本末，事有终始，知所先后则近道矣。这就是在大学里面的这样一句话，是什么意思呢？他就是告诉我们事情有开始有结局，那你要知道前因后果先后的次序，那你就能比较靠近道了。那当然儒家的思想也就只能停在这个程度，但对他们来说什么是道呢？道就是一种自然的规律，自然的法则，他们就停留在这个地方了。但是至少我们的古人们已经知道，已经察觉到次序的一个重要性，先后的重要性。那因此当使徒约翰在这里去说我们能够爱是因为上帝先爱我们，他到底要想讲的是什么呢？那我们很容易就问，什么是上帝的爱呢？为什么我们作为一个普通人好像感受不到上帝的爱？上帝的爱到底是什么呢？好像也离我很远。特别如果你还不是基督徒，你没有读过太多圣经，你可能更是觉得哇，离我好远。那圣经告诉我们上帝的爱到底是什么呢？就在使徒约翰写下这节经文之前，有那么就是在同一章里面他还写下了另外两节经文，我想读给大家听一下。在第九第十节，我们的主题是第十九节，他在同一章的第九第十节，使徒约翰是这么说的，经上说上帝差他的独生子到世间来，使我们借着他得生，上帝爱我们的心在此就显明了，不是我们爱上帝，乃是上帝爱我们，差他的儿子为我们的罪做了挽回祭，这就是爱了。哇，当你如果对圣经不太了解的话，你可能听了会觉得有点好像不太容易理解，为什么上帝差下他的独生子到这个世界来就是彰显他的爱，为什么耶稣所做成的这个挽回祭圣经说这就是上帝的爱了？那这就是我想今天，这就是因为上帝先爱我们这些经文他要表达的意思，也就是我特别想今天要强调的是，当上帝要表达他的爱的时候，他不是用一种我们人能够想象的，如果上帝爱我的话最好帮我的公司马上上市，市值翻个几倍，或者说上帝如果真的爱我的话把我的愿望成就了吧。这是我们人常常有的一种堕落的思维去思想，最好上帝能够满足我的愿望。但圣经里面不是的，圣经里面说上帝爱的一种体现是差遣他的独生子耶稣到这个世界来。如果你不太熟悉圣经没有关系，但是我们或多或少都知道圣经里面最后耶稣是被钉死在十字架上面的。那十字架上面的耶稣的死与复活成为了我们信仰的一个核心，成为了我们对于基督徒来说是一生一世要去思想要去反反复复去思量的一个主题一个内容了。因为上帝是透过这样的一种方式爱我们的，正如前面 Bruintjes 牧师已经提到了，我们每个人其实都没有走在上帝原来创造我们所要我们走的这条道路上面，正如圣经所说个人都偏行己路，圣经还说世人都犯了罪亏缺了上帝的荣耀，因此因为罪恶的缘故使得我们已经没有办法按照上帝原来的心意而生活了，我们按照我们自己的私欲按照我们自己的想法去生活，渐渐的罪恶影响到我们全部的生命，我们活在罪恶之中。那按照圣经所说如果是一个罪人，那将来要面对上帝永恒的永远的审判，那是很可怕的结局，永远的沉沦。那上帝是爱，上帝不愿意我们在末后在将来永恒里面沉沦灭亡，他要拯救我们，他要用从他的方式 用他的方法，从他主权的角度，他要来拯救我们。他怎么拯救我们呢？就是透过耶稣基督进入到这个世界，并死在十字架上的方法。到底是在讲什么意思呢？原来，按照圣经，人犯罪，最后灭亡，每个人又都要承担自己罪恶的刑罚和罪恶的结果。但是，当耶稣在2000年以前为我们死在十字架上的时候，他所做成的，我们称之为救赎，救赎的恩典。那凡是信靠耶稣的人，这表明了我们犯罪，但是最后由耶稣来承担我们罪恶的结局。因此，这是一个奇妙的方法，这是上帝所定的方法。换句话说，我们罪恶的问题不是靠我们自己去做一些好事去将功补过而得到上帝的喜悦，相反，上帝用的方法是信耶稣。信耶稣是什么意思呢？就是相信耶稣的死是为了要承担我的罪恶，耶稣的死为了承担本来应该是我去承受的罪恶的刑罚。这就是上帝的爱了。可能当我们还不了解圣经，我们不太认识我们原来是生活在罪恶中的时候，我们还不能理解上帝的爱所体现的方式。但是圣经是真实的，圣经揭露了我们每一个人生命的真相和本质。世人都犯了罪，没有一个是义人，每个人都是偏行己路，唯独的救恩是出自于耶稣基督。那同样的，另外一位圣徒保罗在罗马书5:8也提到了类似的经文，他说唯有耶稣基督在我们还做罪人的时候为我们死，上帝的爱就在此向我们显明了。所以说，上帝首先爱我们，上帝首先拯救我们，上帝首先挽回我们，把我们从罪恶之中拯救出来，因此我们才有可能去爱，我们才有可能去爱我们的邻舍。这是一个次序的问题。当你真正明白圣经要告诉我们的信息的时候，你会发现，哇，真的就是这样的。我们的爱很多是出于自己的私欲，我们爱我们喜欢的，我们爱我们真的是我们爱的，但是上帝的爱却是一种牺牲的爱，在我们还做罪人的时候，他也就已经爱我们了，为我们死在十字架上。那我想这就是这节经文要告诉我们一个次序的调整。我们爱，我们之所以能够爱，因为上帝先爱我们。这就是简单的音乐会的主题的信息。那我也正好借此机会，也向大家简单的报告一下，明天正好是星期天，是对于基督徒来讲，星期天是主日崇拜上帝的日子。那我们也欢迎你明天下午3:30与我们一同敬拜我们的上帝。那在聚会之后呢，我们还会预备了晚餐。那这次的晚餐我们会预备有中国特色的烧烤，当然是非常美味的，这是家乡的味道。也欢迎大家如果明天愿意来参加我们聚会的话，和我们一起享受上帝的话语，享受上帝的爱，以及彼此相爱。那我想时间差不多，我们的音乐家也已经预备好下半场的音乐会了，那我们就可以继续欣赏美妙的音乐。谢谢。
Mysteries of the seas, So our last piece is called How Deep the Father's Love for Us. In your program, there was a little extra piece of paper. If you could pull that out, we would love you to join us and stand and sing. One small note on the words that are written there. The first verse is accidentally doubled, so don't sing it twice. We're only going to sing it three times. And then we also will not sing the repeat on the end. So just three times. So please join us and sing.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you for the musicians. You know, please give one more applause to our musicians. Thank you, the TNN, and then cast, and the battle, the musicians. Thank you. And thank you for our guests. Thank you for joining us. And you are always welcome to our church. Our church is open to to you, and church is family. We have one Father. God is our Father. So you are always welcome to our worship, join our worship. Our worship service is every Sunday, 9:30 a.m. and 3:30 a.m. p.m. And especially tomorrow, we will have a Chinese BBQ. So please join us for tomorrow. After concert, we prepare the refreshment. So please join the refreshment. The refreshment will be in the fellow hall, fellowship hall. Okay. So I'd like to close in prayer. Shall we pray? Okay. Thank you, Father, for your love, because you loved us first, so that we can love you and so that we can love each other. Father, bless our all musicians who play today, and bless our all guests who come today. Bless our meeting and bless our refreshment, and watch over the way back home. Father, bless our church to love our neighbor more and to share the good news with our neighbor. Father, we love you. Bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, thank you very much. And please join our refreshment. Thank you.